so much. So yeah, let's keep the show on the road and enjoy some Gershwin.
Thank you.
I wanted to put them together because even though they're very far apart in terms of style and years, I think that both of them have some work for the listeners to do. Monk, she composes and paints lots of beautiful pictures with the way that she writes, and Mendelssohn, of course, with the Songs Without Words. There are these melodies that are just begging to have some words, so I challenge you to think about these things as I think. So first, enjoy Monk.
Thank you.
again, everyone, for coming to my recital. It means so much. I want to say thank you to Mom and Dad. I'm so glad you got to make it. Thank you for always just radically supporting me and trusting me through everything. Thank you to all my friends, either here or again through online. Thank you for also supporting me and for just growing with me and entertaining me, making me laugh, and laughing at me. And last, I try to refrain from four-letter words. If no one knows what a four-letter word is, you can ask Dr. Mayerovitch after this. But I hope you know how much that you have helped me grow and refine myself as a musician and as a person. So, pretty much essentially my entire program is made out of these little miniatures instead of, you know, these grander works. And as Dr. Mayerovitch would talk to me about these, he'd have to say, they're pretty hard to pull off because there's so much going on in just a little bit of time. So, but then he would say, if you do pull it off correctly or successfully, then it can be really impactful, really powerful, and it can show so much growth in just a small bit of time. And I started to think about this as a silly little analogy to my time here at BW. Because even though sometimes it was hard to pull off, in such a small amount of time in my life, it's been so impactful, powerful, and I've learned so much. So thank you, everyone. And I wanted to end with something really fun. So I really enjoyed playing these bar talk or meeting dances. They've been so entertaining, and I hope you all enjoy. So thank you again for coming out. Thank you. So my good friend Nick and I have been making music together all throughout these past 4 years, putting different covers and performances together for various different events and things. And the first thing that we put together was You Make Me Feel So Young. So I wanted to revive that today and put our own new little spin on it. And also in doing so, give a little ode to our music ed program and all of the different tools and resources that it's provided for us. So hopefully you see a little bit of that in this today. So here it is, enjoy.
Every time I I wanted to share this song with you all by Nora Jones. I've always loved Nora Jones as an artist. She's been such a comfort to me. Especially recently, I would so often find myself yelling at my Google to play Nora Jones, and it would always play the same order, so the first song would always be the same, I'm Alive. So I got to know it very well, and I didn't know it before. And I'd actually learned that the song was written very recently, so much so that it was about this past year and everything that had happened within it. And I thought it was really interesting because I was finding myself looking for comfort in her music, in this song, and I was looking for hypothetical comfort, comfort I could use in my own way when I could actually find literal comfort within it. We were thinking about the same thing and we were looking for that comfort in our music in the same way. So I really thought that was cool and I wanted to share it with you. So here's I'm Alive by Nora Jones.
Oh.
slide.